Hey everyone, Shin Virtuality here with another, a different game to show. Seeing my first three videos, I would only stream PUBG, but there's a couple other games that have piqued my interest, and this is but one of them, Skullgirls Mobile. Been playing this for the last year and a half, pretty much every day, on my way into work and whatnot. It's nice to just sort of knock off a couple of quick matches on the bus. So I just wanted to get a video going and show you a little bit on what the game holds. If you like fighters on mobile, drop me a comment and tell me, you know, which ones you like. Do you like this one? Do you like other fighting games for mobile, whether it's like Mortal Kombat or Street Fighter or some of the ones that they make specifically for touchscreen? I'm just going to go quickly through how you can get fighters, how you can control fighters, and go through a couple of matches and just show you what the game has in store. The game will have a big update coming out soon with another fighter available, and I wanted to cover that, but not as like a first look for this game. So I'm hoping that this video will sort of accomplish that. So we'll just quickly go into my collection for a minute. And like I said, I've been playing for a while, so my collection is quite large with a lot of high-level characters. When you start off, you'll be starting off with bronze tier fighters, just to give you an idea. Bronze, all covered with bronze. But then you will level up and you can get access to silver tier, whether by leveling up your bronze and involving it, or getting a silver character through relics, which are like things that random chests that you can open up, and they hold fighters and moves and other stuff like that. And then from silver is the gold tier, which are like the very high level fighters. And with the last update, they introduced diamond tier, which you can evolve gold from. And they take a lot of resources to get here. I have all but one of them, but that's fine. At least I have one. So we'll do that. And then each character has sort of like an element type. From what you can see in the filter screen, you have fire types, water types, air types, light types, and dark types. The diamond right there is like a no element, and I think it's only specific for one character. But if I say I want to filter in my fire types, you can see like they're all red. So it's easy distinguishing what type they are. So I'll just get the filter up again. Fire types are strong against air types. Air types strong against water types. Water types strong against fire types. And then the light and the dark are strong against each other. So when light types and dark types are fighting each other, their hits to the opposite element will hit stronger. And then from there, you get characters, and there's currently 11 in the game so far. Like I said, the next update will introduce the 12th. But let's click on Big Ban for a moment. And we'll just go into my Beatbox Big Ban, because this character is fully leveled up. So we'll go into his skill tree. When you get characters, they start at level 1, and as you level them up, they get character points that you can use to unlock character abilities, whether it's like specific for that character, added strength, added health, added moves. You can expand your roster of moves and move points. And then your energy cooldown timers. So we'll just take a quick look at each one. If we start at the top and go clockwise, this top one is like character abilities. So you get your specific character ability, and for Big Ben, it's while dashing, he cannot be interrupted unless he takes, but will take damage normally. So the first hit will hit at full strength, but he won't be interrupted, so he can continue on his combo until like a second hit lands. And then even going down the tree, you can get advanced combo, so you can get more hits for your combo, an advanced chuggle, which sort of unlocks extra hits when you have opponents up in the air, a charge attack. All characters have charge attack, but this just makes those charge attacks unblockable. And then specific signature abilities for said characters. So if I were to, say, go back a screen, signature abilities, as you see on the right-hand side, I gain Enrage for this character for 5 seconds when using a special move, and then I gain special 25% meter for all blockbusters. Those are like the special super moves when using a special move. So let's go back into the skill tree, and I'll just go through the rest. I said going clockwise, these are just energy cooldown timers. Each one reduces cooldown by 2%, but you also get a couple of them for tagging cooldown, so when you're tagging in other characters, or special moves. Whenever you use a special move, the time to decrease its timer is reduced by leveling it up. Next slot here is for health. So as you unlock this, you get more and more health. With a block proficiency for some, decreases damage when blocking, and overall defense reduction. Next one around is your special move tree, and the ones with the plus sign are just to unlock other moves. You start off with 2, and you can unlock 3 more for a total of 5. And then your points upgrade. So as you level up these, you get more points that you can associate with special moves and blockbusters. And then the last tree here is just for attack damage. So overall attack damage with slots for increasing crit rate by 5% and increasing crit damage by 5%. And that's the character tree. And then in the center, once you have all of this unlocked, you can go hit the center, and this will unlock your marquee ability. You can pick one or the other depending on your playstyle. And then once you have the ability, you can use gold and character points to start leveling up those. And then heading back into the character, you can actually... won't use involve, but I am now in a position where this character is silver. I can use other big bands to increase him to a gold tier if I so wanted to. And if I wasn't level 40, I can sacrifice characters to just level him up faster. And then at the top, got stats. Oops. So various things like crit rate and block proficiency and your percentage to stun or bleed or cripple. So always nice stuff. And then your equip screen. So as you can see down at the bottom, I have my moves for Big Ben equipped. But let me go to a level 1 to better illustrate this. So same character, level 1. If I go into the skill tree, nothing's unlocked, so I'd have to use points to level up the tiers and trees and keys to unlock further. But if I go into the equip screen and say I wanted to equip this brass knuckles, just press equip and then a slot to put it in. But then say I want to use a blockbuster and I want to use, say, this tuba tuba blockbuster. Down by my moves on the left, you can see that I'm using 2 out of a total of 8. But because this move takes 8 more points to equip, if I try to equip it, it'll say I've exceeded the maximum. So that's why I can't equip it. So as you unlock, your points for that increases, and then you're allowed to increase or to equip more moves and fill out your skill set accordingly. So that's the characters. I'm just going to quickly go into training, and I'll show you how you can control the characters. Let's keep on with my big band examples. So I'll equip a level 1 beatbox, and then my level 40 silver. And then I'll just throw in another character for another parasol. And we'll hit fight. And training is just used to try out moves, use your combos, you know, test out a couple of things. You have an opponent here that's not going to attack you, just going to stand there and be your punching bag until you decide to exit. So when I'm just standing here, you're controlling the game with two thumbs. The character, when not touching the screen, he'll stand there for a moment and then move towards your opponent. Fair to point out that your character is always on the left and the enemy character is always on the right. So then if I hold the screen with both thumbs and just sort of tap and hold, the character will block. And it's probably one of the more important moves that you'll have to learn throughout the game. If you're blocking effectively, you can counter when the character, when the enemy character is open for attack, and getting your combos that way. And then just to dish out moves, tapping the screen will throw out various basic moves. So if I continue to tap the screen, it'll come out with its particular combo. For this character, it's just like a 1-2-3. And then if I 1-2-3 and then swipe up, it'll launch the character into the air. So that's 1-2-3 launch. And then from there, I can 1-2-3 launch and then keep tapping the screen, and that will follow the character up into the air for an airborne combo. As such, if I 1-2-3 and hit down, that will be like a low attack. So 1-2-3 low. So let's hit to the edge of the screen here because the characters hit the walls. Just to illustrate and launch, and then low attack as they come down for another extra hit. So all in all, you can see where the combos start coming into play here. That's combos, and then if you take both thumbs and then swipe in any direction, but they must be the same direction, so I'll use up as an example. If I take both thumbs and swipe up, that's a throw. And that's pretty much your basic attacks here. So if I throw, and then if the enemy character does the same motion immediately within the start of the throw animation, they'll break out of it. As such, if the enemy throws me and I do the same motion, I can break out of their throws. So let me call in. Let's see if I can do this. You can call it and you can tag in your teammates. There we go. So I launched the character in the air, tagged in. Tag-in's will do an extra hit if timed correctly. Which is why I got the extra hit for Big Band. So Big Band's tag in is just a straightforward punch. I'll just wait for the timers to reset. And I'll do Parasol next. Each character has their own sort of tag in attack. So let's see if I can do it here. Launch, and then, yeah, I got an extra hit. The bike that Parasol rode in does an attack, but Parasol jumps off sort of from a safe distance. So, Bing, bring, Big Ben back in just to illustrate. So this is my leveled up character. So if I do a basic combo for him, you can see lots more hits. Finisher for the launcher, and same thing for the low attack. I also have my special abilities here, as you can see on the bottom of my screen. So if I start a combo, do a cymbal clash, and then end off with a supersonic jazz, blockbuster, nice little combo there. And part of the fun is just sort of getting moves, leveling them up, and just seeing, you know, what works. If I do this and then do that, and then I can combo as they come down. I can even get into, oh yeah, I can get into another. I need to get my move charged up again. Special moves will become available over time, where blockbusters you have to hit or be hit in order to charge up them. So if I do the same thing again, and then I extend the combo, and then supersonic jazz, that will hit at the end as well. And if I time it right, I can get more hits as they come down. So you can see how that all works. And so let's jump out of this quickly, and then I'll get into a couple of matches, and then you can see how the game is actually played. Quit. Good, good. We'll go into daily events. And we'll do... These are just daily events, so because it's Sunday, you get the choice of doing Parasol or Eliza here, which I've already done. Accursed Experiments is a weekly one, so from Sunday to Sunday, if I complete this, I get the rewards associated for it. And then it shows me the next couple of days. So on Monday it's Philia, Monday it is also Squiggly. Tuesday Big Ban, Wednesday is Beowulf and Valentine, and so on and so forth. So we'll just go back to the beginning here. We'll just do a couple of Parasol in Master Tier, because I have characters that can do that kind of. And then we'll just scroll out, so much like this. And in story mode, which I've completed as well, you're given a roadmap with particular fights, and then as you clear those fights, they'll open up the road for other fights. So let's go down to this 3-1. So I'm going to go back because I want to illustrate fighter score with you guys. So let's go to this one instead, because this will be easier to understand. At the top, my two big bands, because they are bronze and silver, they have a total fighter score of 3,881, as you can see at the top, center. And then the opponents I'm fighting have a total fighter score of 10,000. So it's sort of not in my favor to take these two into battle. So let's put the odds a little bit in my favor, shall we? We'll take this Squiggly. And this double. And then if we back out, then we can see that these two characters have a fighter score of 12,000. So a little bit better odds for matching up against in this fight. So we'll just do that.
Curse you. Showtime.
Oh, missed that. Special move. Oh, that's a blockbuster. Finish it off. And when you finish off the last opponent with a blockbuster, you get a nice little flashy ending there, like you just saw. All in all, not bad. And at the end, you get some gold and a little bit of XP for your fighters, and you go on to the next one. So like I said before, and that sort of unlocks the road, so now I have that fight available, which I'm just not going to do, and the one up here available. I'm just going to change this around so I can illustrate other fighters. Have enough energy to counter it, so I think that was it for her. Blockbuster. This is not going to have the energy to block that. So I get to cheaply chip damage her to death. Couple more fights here. I'll go down to these ones. That's why I didn't do these ones before, because I can't tell what the fighter score for the enemy team was going to be, because I don't know what fighters they're going to pit me against. But it shouldn't be that hard. I'll use Pea Sugar Peacock, a bad Miss Frosty Philia, and Nearly Departed Squiggly.
Target confirmed.
Showtime.
Ooh. Just got me on a stun. But that's fine. Not effectively blocking. There. Trying to taunt me. Not gonna work today. Sorry. Nice little banter between characters. Oh, you may have noticed a lot of tongue-in-cheek puns as well, either in the character names or the move names. This game's free to download on Apple and Android, so I do recommend picking it up if this looks like your cup of tea. Again, change out another fighter here just to sort of see. Oops, you got me.
What?
Oops. That blockbuster was a throw, so it was pretty much unblockable anyway. Yeah, I'll do a couple more just to show you guys, and then call it there's something you would like to see that I haven't shown in this video, by all means, drop me a comment. See what you would like to see, and I'll see if I can show it in a future video. Let me back out first. So this one is a special kind of fight, and it has requirements up at the top here. I must have a parasol on my team, so because my character is Cerebella, let's go in here, and if I hit the check mark, that shows me all the characters that I can use in order to meet this match's requirements. So let me just pull on this egrets parasol and hit the go button.
I'll show you how to deal with traitors.
Showtime!
Character's got a couple of buffs. I think his one is immune. Yeah. Character was not taking any damage as well. But those have expired, so now I'm free to do whatever I need to do. Blockable, so let's make sure I get out of range of that. And for these matches as well with the gold, I get some shards, elemental shards. They're used to upgrade gold level fighters to diamond tier and a special move. And since this character is max level, I'm not getting any XP for it, but that's fine. And let's do one more. Now, if I really wanted to, since I see that this is a dark type character, I can pull in a light type. So let me pull in my Epic Sax Big Band, one of my favorite characters. If I go in, I can actually check his abilities. He's max level, but I gain 3% damage per combo hit, up to 50. So since this character actually hits a lot, so he'll get a lot of combo hits just doing his basic combos, and then I get a random buff for every 10 combo hits. So that's why this character is so beastly. That's why I like it. Couldn't even finish off one combo. That's how powerful the elemental statuses are between characters, and always good to bear that in mind when picking your fighters for the next match. Oh, and I get my showtime, so let me head back to the main screen and I'll show you that unlocked one of my daily missions. Daily missions you can do to get more Theonite, which is your real money currency for this game. But you can get some just by doing events or doing your missions that come on a daily basis. So since I won 20 fights, I can claim that and get another 15 Theonite. So you click on that and you can get Canopy coins for Theonite or Theonite for real money. But that is Skullgirls Mobile. Let me know what you guys think. Did you like what you see? Do you want to see more? What are your favorite fighters on mobile? What do you guys like to play? Do you like a little Mortal Kombat, a little Street Fighter, or something else that is out in the mobile space. And if you like this game, what would you like to see more of? I'll definitely be doing another video when the next update hits, because there'll be the new character, which is Miss Fortune. I wanted to have that character in the game from the get-go, and she's finally making an appearance, so that is awesome news and can't come soon enough. As well as another feature that will be implemented is increasing your collection for fighters and moves. You can see at the bottom I'm one away from maxing out my fighters and 8 moves over, so I can't collect more moves until I do something with the excess 8 that I have. Which is fine, I can just sell them off for more gold coins. But it'll be nice to increase those and up my collection even more. Anyway, like I said, that's Skullgirls Mobile. Drop a like and subscribe to my channel if you like what you see. And as always, game on, have fun, and we'll see you all in the next one. Thanks for watching. Yeah!